5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। वन ऑफ द सीरियस प्रॉब्लम्स विच हैज़ बीन डील्ड विद इज द फूड सिचुएशन इन द कंट्री। द प्रेसिडेंट्स एड्रेस वेरी राइटली रिमार्क्ड दैट दो इट इज नॉट अलार्मिंग स्टिल इट इज सीरियस, इट इज ऑफ ग्रेव कंसर्न। द इकोनॉमी इन द कंट्री इज ऑल्सो नॉट वेरी सेफ। ऑल दीज आर स्टार्क रियलिटीज विच द कंट्री एंड द लीडर्स ऑफ सोसाइटी एज वी आर इन दिस अगस्ट हाउस विल हैव टू फेस। दिस अगस्ट हाउस एंड ऑल्सो द सेवरल हाउसेस इन द स्टेट्स have given their approval to the 10th 5-year plan. It has been approved and it is already working, though its first year of progress may be very slow for several regions beyond the control of the government of India. However, the food situation in the country indicates as the statistics given by the Ministry of Agriculture show that there is a steady increase in the production and as such they have sounded a note of cautious optimism, though it may not have been appreciated by several cities as well as several people in the country because of the rising trend of prices. The rising trend of prices during the last 2 or 3 months clearly goes to show that the food situation is not satisfactory. I do not venture to say that it is deteriorating, but as somebody has remarked, the food situation appears to be a little grave because of lack of purchasing power of the consumer. In regard to food production, there are 3 factors. One is the producer, the other is the non-producer, and the third is the government. The producer in this country is mainly the agriculturist, and it is time to think seriously whether the Union Parliament should have to think positively whether in this country agriculture is to be given the pride of place ahead of industry, because it is the main industry of the nation. There is a clear distinction between agriculture and industry, and as it has been said by an eminent economist, there cannot be better industry unless there is an improved agriculture. An improved agriculture needs several factors to be considered before we assail the producer in the country. Fortunately, very many speakers who preceded me have sponsored the cause of the producer, though the producer was not so much in the picture. The producers in this country can be divided into 3 categories. Sir, from my little experience of the rural areas, I can say that growing a food is not a paying proposition to the agriculturists unless and until the prices of food grains are guaranteed. Ours is a marginal production and we have to see whether this marginal production is to be stepped up to the point of self-sufficiency, in which case we have to see whether the producer needs any protection, whether guarantees can be given as regards the prices of food grains, whether parity of prices can be maintained for food grains vis-a-vis industrial products in our country. If these factors are not taken into consideration, then, sir, poverty will not be liquidated, and unless and until we take the food problem as the vital problem of the nation, I think we will be day by day disappointed in our attempts to relieve the food situation. The food situation is becoming grave because our fast expanding money economy has put more money in the pockets of the people. I have no quarrel with it because the country needs to give relief to the persons who are not well placed in life. But this money economy has played havoc among the rank and file of the various producers in agriculture because, after all, in India, even now, more than 75% of the people depend on agriculture, and if there is a great disparity in income between the industrial labor and agricultural labor, the agricultural labor has no incentive. The smallholder has no incentive to produce more. Besides, growing food grains, as I said, is not a paying proposition, and so the balance is tilted in favor of cash crops. Various state governments have also abolished the Grow More Food Acts. Especially in Maharashtra, there is an act called the Grow More Food Act of 1995. It lays down certain restrictions on the grower to assign more land for food production. That restriction having been removed, now the farmer is an individualist in his crop planning and he does not care what crop the country needs, but he cares more for whether the crop is a paying proposition. It is a natural human tendency that unless and until the business is remunerative, nobody follows it seriously. Though this tendency is found not only in India, but everywhere, at the agriculturist faces this question all the more. Sir, our revered Prime Minister made a nationwide appeal that India should follow cooperative farming. Sir, cooperative farming still remains a dead letter, though there have been several eminent persons who have advocated the importance of cooperative farming.